Thank you.
Adrian, what did you see in that third quarter that just, I mean, you guys just never really seemed to find your rhythm until kind of the fourth quarter. I mean, what was kind of the holdup in the third quarter for you guys?
I can't say right now. I can't sit here and point at one thing. You know, I'd have to go back and watch the film, but you're right. You know, that third quarter, the offense needed to go try and put the game away, go make a drive, make something happen. And we can't afford that type of quarter, those type of possessions. You know, we didn't help out our defense, you know, and we weren't being good teammates.
Adrian, how would you describe the emotional swings of this game?
Yeah, you know, you said it, emotional swings. Obviously, I have 17-0 at halftime, but I think qualities of a good football team is not letting that get to you. You know, the flea flicker thing, and then we come back and have another long touchdown. There are a lot of significant events, but, you know, had to keep your head level and play your game. And I think we could probably do a better job of that as a team.
How tough is this after last year not being able to finish out the game and watching the sideline and winning it at your home? You're up, you're dominating, you're ranked. What was, and I think you had most of the crowd, too.
Yeah. Yeah, well, we let our fans down, and we let Coach Frost down, and I wanted this game, you know, and we wanted this game. We had that mindset coming in, and we lost, plain and simple. We're going to have to bounce back. It's tough. It's tough, but like I told those guys in the locker room, remember this. Remember this feeling. Let's not feel it again. You know, it's tough. Stuff happens, but good teams will bounce back. Great teams will be even better. So that's where my head's at right now. Obviously, I feel terrible. You know, we wanted to win this game, but we're going to bounce back.
Did you think the play before the interception, the regulation, do you think you had cat by the sideline?
Can't say I specifically remember the play, so I can't give you a good answer.
The turnovers continue to be an issue today.
Yeah.
How significant is that? Even though you had a fan advantage, is this still an environment away from home, or maybe that's magnified?
Well, yeah, I think whether you're home, whether you're away, turnovers is a stat that means a lot. It could be the tell of the game, and that's something I have to do a better job of, and this offense needs to do a better job of. Obviously, all the three turnovers came from me, and that's something that we're going to continue to work on and get better at. You know, we know that good teams can't turn over the ball that much and expect to win a game.
Did the sack in overtime, did he kind of sneak in on you? I mean, is that a situation where you intend to throw it away if you know you're under pressure, or what happened there?
Well, I was probably looking to throw across the seam there to Wandale, but kind of got stopped. And, again, I'll have to look back on film, but he kind of caught me in the middle of two things, at a bad spot.
Did that snap, that low snap, affect you?
I wouldn't say so. You know, you got to make things happen. You know, I'm not going to sit here and make excuses for anything. And that's on me. Whether the snap was freaking 5,000 feet over my head, I don't care. There's no excuses. You know, and I think that's an important thing for this team to know and a lesson to myself. You know, regardless of where the snap is, who gives? You know, I got to be able to make the play. You know, excuse my language. All right.
Mo Berry back here.